Well, good news. We have an opportunity to see how to update Drupal core using Composer. Today, I noticed that overnight, there had been a security release to Drupal core. I know this because if I go to any administrative section in my Drupal site, such as configuration, I see this error message. There is a security update available for your version of Drupal. To ensure the security of your server, you should update immediately. See the available updates page for more information and how to install your missing updates. Now, because we're running this site locally on our machine, I know that I could likely safely ignore this message. However, security updates need to be taken seriously, and it's best practice to handle security updates as quickly as possible. In any case, we need to learn how to update Drupal core anyway, so now is a perfect time to do this. So let's click on See the Available Updates page. And sure enough, currently I'm running Drupal version 9.1.0. And just last night, there was an unannounced security update released. This new recommended version is Drupal core 9.1.3. These quick security fixes are one of the many things that I appreciate about Drupal. There is a dedicated security team making sure that Drupal is as secure as possible. Thank you, Drupal security. So what follows is I'm going to show you how to update Drupal core using Composer, and I'm going to show you the process that I use to update my Drupal sites. So the first thing that we can do here is read the release notes for the recommended version. On the right-hand side here, I see there's a release notes link, so I'm going to open the release notes in a new tab. And here we go. It looks like this release fixes security vulnerabilities, and we are urged to update immediately. If we want to see more specifics about the security update, we can click on this Drupal core critical third-party library link. I'll open in a new tab. Here we get more context. According to the description, this vulnerability is within the third-party pair archive underscore tar library. How awesome is this? A security vulnerability is found in an independent third-party library that Drupal happens to use, and the Drupal security team updates Drupal core and lets all of us Drupal users know about it. Thank you to those that reported it, and especially those who fixed it. Okay, going back to the Drupal 9.1.3 release notes, we've determined that this update is to fix third-party library code, and as such, this core update likely will not affect any Drupal database tables. However, because I'm currently running Drupal 9.1.0, I'm actually going to go back and look at the release notes for Drupal 9.1.1 and 9.1.2 just to see if there's any additional steps that I need to take for those particular updates. To read those release notes, here above the Drupal 9.1.3 release notes, if I right-click on this releases link, that's going to bring me to the release notes for all the Drupal releases. So let's filter by the version we're running, which in this case is 9.1. Type that in version starts with 9.1, and then click filter. Now, we can open the release notes for 9.1.1, the release notes for 9.1.2, and we already have the release notes for 9.1.3 to open. The notes for 9.1.1 say this is a patch file and is ready for production use. Okay, this detail is important. It says this release was mistagged. Use Drupal 9.1.2 instead. Good enough. I'll close a tab and quickly scan the 9.1.2 release notes. This release was also a patch bug fix release. Reading the important update information, this release hot fixes an issue with the 9.1.1 tag, which we knew about. CK editor has been updated, this time for a security fix that does not affect Drupal. Excellent, can't be too safe. And finally, it looks like Chrome Drive, a JavaScript development dependency, has been updated. Notice that in all the release notes, there was no mention of Drupal database updates. This is important because it means our update is likely going to be straightforward because it's code changes, which do not affect the database structure of our site. We will see the impact of this soon. For now, keep database updates in the back of your mind. At this time, let's begin to update our Drupal core version using Composer. The crucial takeaway from updating with Composer is that you need to run the correct Composer command in the correct location in the command line. Even if you're not overly comfortable with working on the command line, as long as you can determine the correct composer command to run and then run it from the correct directory, then you can update Drupal core with composer with confidence. First, in a new tab, open drupal.org/docs/updating-drupal, which lists details for the various methods of updating Drupal. Again, the actual workflow will be up to you and your team depending on how the Drupal codebase is managed. If you have not yet converted your site to a composer-based workflow, I highly recommend that you take time to understand the benefits of doing so and how to do it. It is a straightforward conversion process, and the future of Drupal is strongly reliant on Composer, so it will behoove you to do the Composer converting sooner rather than later. One thing to highlight is that if you are using Composer to manage Drupal, then you should not use Drush to download projects into Drupal. Always use Composer if you are using Composer. Drush can still be used for site activities such as clearing cache, and we'll see that in a moment. But as a rule of thumb, use Composer to install and remove dependencies and use Drush for site building activities. Let's open the link for updating Drupal core via Composer. I'm excited to show you how straightforward this is. Basically, we just need to follow these instructions step by step. Look here at these special considerations. At this point, Drupal really does have strong documentation behind it, although admittedly you do have to find it. Like it says, if you're updating from a Drupal version earlier than 8.8.0, you'll likely need to make some one-time changes. Follow that guide to get started. Or, if you did not install Drupal via Composer, and it is not yet converted to a Composer-managed project, you'll need to do so by following this guide, the Add Composer to Existing Sites guide. Of course, neither of these considerations apply to us because if you have been following along with this course, you would have originally created your site using Composer. Moving on. Next, we need to determine which scaffolding package that our Drupal install is currently using. We don't need to get too into the weeds on this topic, so simply put, the scaffolding is a template that tells Composer which directories to put certain types of files, such as Drupal core, Drupal modules and themes, third-party libraries, etc. To check which scaffold project is in place, we run the command composer show. Specifically, we run composer show Drupal/core-recommended. The output given from this command tells us which update command we should run. If the output is one way, we do one thing, and if the output is something different, we do the other command. Now is a good time to remember that to successfully complete updating Drupal using Composer, you need to run the correct command and you need to run it from the correct directory in the command line. These two steps are situationally dependent on your environment. For me, since I am using DDEV to run my Drupal sites locally, I have the command line open to the base directory of my site, which contains the composer.json and composer.lock files. Here is where I need to run the command composer show Drupal/core-recommended. Again, since I am using DDEV, I need to prepend this command with DDEV so that the command runs correctly. The essential composer command to run is composer show, and how you run that is dependent upon your environment. So if you are using Lando, it would be Lando composer show Drupal/core-recommended, for example. Okay, so I'll hit enter to run the composer show Drupal/core-recommended command, and I'll wait for it to report back. Awesome! So, after running the command composer show Drupal/core-recommended, we do see a listing. Here on the documentation page, it says that if Drupal core recommended is installed, this command returns information about the package. And so sure enough, on my command line, I do have output from this command, meaning we do have Drupal core recommended project installed. Let's remember this detail for now and go on to the next step. The next step is to check for available Drupal updates. Of course, we already know that there will be updates because that's what our site says. But to verify and follow along with the instructions, let's run this composer outdated command. Be sure to copy every composer command exactly as shown, or you will run into errors. Pressing enter, and let's see what happens. Give it a little time to investigate and report back. Remember, when working with the command line, you may not always get immediate feedback. In fact, as a general principle, getting no feedback means that no errors have been encountered. And as long as you see this blinking cursor, then you know that it is at least processing something. Here we go. Sure enough, 4 Drupal projects are marked as outdated. They are listed here: Drupal Core, Core Composer Scaffold, Core Project Message, and Drupal Core Recommended. Now that we have verified that some Drupal projects, in our case Drupal Core, are outdated, let's continue on to the next step of actually updating Drupal Core. Here at this next step, we need to remember that in my case, the site I am demonstrating was installed with the meta package Core Recommended. We learn this by running the Composer Show command up here. So in this case, we need to run this Composer command exactly: Composer update Drupal / core, quote, Drupal / core - star, quote, --, with - all - dependencies. Recall that for me to run Composer commands, I need to prepend them with ddev, which acts as a wrapper to a Composer command of the container running my local Drupal site. Let's break this command down. The first part is Composer update, which is going to update the code for us. The code that is going to be updated is Drupal / core and any package beginning with Drupal / core - This star acts as a wildcard. This core - star will update the core - composer - scaffold, core - composer - message, and core - recommended. This option of --, with all dependencies, tells Composer to also update dependencies of packages in the argument list, including those which are not root requirements. Remember the release notes of Drupal Core version 9.1.3? Remember the security issue was for the pair package called archive_tar? It is because of this --, with all dependencies option present that we will likely see the pair archive_tar package also updated and installed at the same time as these Drupal packages. After we have double-checked that we have typed the Composer command exactly, press Enter. We'll need to wait for a bit while Composer does the hard work of finding dependencies and bringing in the correct updated code. Fantastic! So Composer has updated Drupal Core without any errors. So let's take a look for a brief moment to examine what happened. Oh, this is awesome. Sure enough, Drupal Core has been updated. Core-Composer Scaffold, Core Project Message, and Core Recommended have been updated too. And look at this. Here is the pair archive_tar package that had the security risk. It's been updated also, along with all these other dependencies of the updated packages. Awesome. Okay, going back to the update documentation. The next step is to run database updates. Recall that our prediction is that after reading through the release notes, we do not anticipate there being any database updates. Here is where we will find out. It says we can either use Drush or we can visit update.php on our site. I'll demonstrate both ways. With new versions of Drush, it's recommended to install it via Composer. Previous to this video, I have done this. But in order to access Drush, I need to be inside the container running my Drupal site. To do that, because I'm running ddev, I need to run the command ddev ssh. Of course, your exact command will be different on how you set up your environment. Now that I am inside the ddev container, I will run drush-V to see which version I'm running. And sure enough, it's a modern version of Drush. Now that I've verified that Drush is installed on this Drupal project, and I've verified it's a recent version, I will go back to the documentation and see which commands need to be run. The command is drush update db. As expected, there are no pending database updates. For good measure though, I'll follow the documentation and run this next command of cache rebuild. Super! Cache rebuild complete! The other option to update the database is to visit /update.php in our browser. Make sure you are signed in as user 1. Although we could get there by simply visiting update.php in the URL bar, I want to show you another way to get there. If you click on Manage, Extend, above the filter box, you'll see a sentence that says to always run the update script each time a module is updated. This link also takes us to update.php. If this was an actual production site, you would be wise to follow the instructions given, backing up your code with source control, making database backups, etc. Once you've done that, click Continue. As expected, we see that there are no pending updates, the same conclusion that Drush gave us. Let's go back to our site to see if Drupal has been updated. I'll click on Administration Pages. Once back, I'll visit Reports. Then, I'll click the Available Updates report. Fantastic! Drupal has been updated to 9.1.3. Congratulations on learning how to update Drupal Core with Composer. Remember, the key takeaways are that you need to run the correct Composer command exactly, and you need to run the command in the directory that contains your site's composer.json file. This is all for now. Nice job, and happy learning.